Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the .NET MAUI calendar control. Using calendar control, you can display the date and days of the week, which provides month, year, decade, and century to quickly navigate to the desired date. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed on your machine. You should also have an IDE installed with the required .NET MAUI workloads. With that confirmed, let's start building an app. I open Visual Studio and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose MAUI app and name my project MAUI example. After that, I continue with the .NET 7 framework and click Create to complete the project creation. Alright, my default application has been created, so let's check the MAUI application's default output by running it. Before that, I choose the Android emulator from this list and select a Pixel 5 emulator in which to see the output. The application is compiling the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. Look here, my application says Hello World, welcome to MAUI app. Next, I will show you the steps to display the SyncFusion.NET MAUI calendar control. First, I need to install the SyncFusion.NET MAUI calendar NuGet package. So, I stop the debugging and open the NuGet package manager. In the Browse tab, I search for the SyncFusion.NET MAUI calendar package and install it in my project. I click OK to continue the installation. It takes a few seconds to complete. Okay, now let's initialize the .NET MAUI calendar control. Before that, I need to register the SyncFusion.NET MAUI trial license key. I open this app XAML CS file and register the trial license key using the register license method. To generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Next, I need to register the handler for SyncFusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native Vue API. So, I open the MAUI program CS file and add the SyncFusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then, I register the SyncFusion core handler by making a call to the method configure SyncFusion core. Next, I will initialize the control. First, I open this mainpage.xaml file and remove the default content from the content page section. Inside this page, I import the SyncFusion MAUI calendar package namespace. And I include the MAUI calendar control. Okay, everything needed for rendering the control is configured. I save the changes and run this application. You can see the calendar displayed with default month view showing the current date. Though the calendar control is displaying the month view, you can switch to other views like year, decade, and century. Suppose I want to display the decade view at initial load. I will add the view property and set its value to decade. Checking now, the calendar control shows the decade view initially. Notice here that the first day of the week is Sunday. But I can set a custom day of the week by using the first day of week property. First, I include the month view tag and add the calendar month view definition. Then, I define the first day of week property and assigning it a value. Here, I set the value Tuesday. Also, let me remove the view property from the code, as I plan to display calendar in month view. Observe the calendar control, it displays Tuesday as the first day of the week. Next, I will show you how to set custom number of visible week in the month. To demonstrate, let me add the number of visible weeks property and set it value to 3. Also, I am going to show week numbers, so add the show week number property with the value true. See here, only 3 weeks are displayed in the month view, along with week numbers. By default, I can select a date from the calendar. If I want to select multiple dates, then simply set the selection mode to multiple. See here, I can select multiple dates from the calendar. In addition to this multiple selection mode, there is one more selection mode called range, which allows you to select a range of dates. To demonstrate this, let me change the selection mode property to range. Now, the calendar control allows you to select dates in a range. By default, you can select the dates in the default range selection direction. But, control supports other range selection directions like forward, backward, both, and none. I am planning to allow date selection only in the forward direction, so let me add the range selection direction property and set its value to forward. Look here, I can select only the dates after the selected range start date. Dates before the range start date are disabled, and the start date will not be changed. Suppose I would like to select the dates in the backward. Just set the range selection direction property to backward. When I select only the dates before the selected range end date, while dates after the range end date are disabled. In case, I set the range selection direction to both, then you select dates either in forward or backward direction. Suppose, I want to disable all the dates except selected date range, then change the range selection direction to none. Check now, once the date range is selected, other dates are disabled in the calendar. By default, the date selection shape will be circle. But, I can change the shape by setting the selection shape to rectangle. See now, when I select a date, the selection shape is rectangle. Observe that, you can navigate between the views vertically. I can also navigate horizontally by setting the navigation direction to horizontal. Now, I can only navigate the calendar horizontally. By default, the view navigation and navigation arrows are enabled in the calendar control. Suppose I want to prevent view navigation and disable the navigation arrows. Let me set the allow view navigation property to false. Then, I will add header view tag and add the calendar header view definition with the show navigation arrows property to false. Look here, I cannot navigate between the views and the navigation arrows are hidden. By default, the dates before the today's date are enabled. If I want to disable them, I simply set the enable past dates property to false. See now, the dates before today's date are disabled. Next, I will show you how to display custom calendar dates by setting minimum and maximum date properties. I am planning to display dates from February 27, 2023 to March 8, 2023. So I add the minimum date and maximum date properties to those values. Check now, only the specified dates are displayed. Next, let's see how to customize the header appearance in the calendar. Here, I can customize the header using height, background, text style, and text format properties. I am going to add a background color and text style, so first let me define the background property to green. Then, I will include the text style tag and add a calendar text style definition to set custom text style. Here, I will add font size property with the value 18. Looking at the calendar now, the headers are shown in custom background color and text style is applied. Finally, I am going to display the disabled dates in different color. So, I add the disabled dates background property with color code. Check now, the disabled dates are shown in different color. In this video, we have seen how to create a .NET MAUI app using Visual Studio 2022, how to add the SyncFusion.NET MAUI calendar control to the app, and how to customize it. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.